Hancock is a very small New England village located in the southern part of New Hampshire, not far from the city of Keene. Today in 2012, it really doesn't look a heck of a lot different than it did in 1955. Pretty much the same town. As a boy, I really didn't care much about spaceships or Flash Gordon or Moon Men, sci-fi of any kind. I was really more interested in the cowboy movies, Gene Autry, Roy Rogers, Hoppy, and the like. I loved those pictures. I guess as teenagers, my cousin Jerry, myself, and Bob Fogg were pretty normal. We hung out in the summer of 1955, and my friends Ron Noftel and Russell Nylander and I all ended up in the old Home Day Parade that year. So we really had a good time back in those days. Up on Norway Hill in the 1950s, this house belonged to Charlie Fogg. And he'd built a recreation room for us kids, and we spent a lot of time there. And after the evening was over, I would often ride my bicycle back along Antrim Road, over the hill, down to Brimstone Corner Road, which began about here. In those days, it was a pretty lonely road, and the only house on it that was occupied, other than my own, was the Harold Stearns farm. So as you can see, it's a pretty long, lonely stretch of dirt road, unlighted. This house in the 1950s was owned by the Welch family and sold to Jim White. Directly across from it is the pasture with the stone wall. It's somewhat more grown up now than it was then, but this is where everything started, right here beyond these trees. Anyway, I was riding my bicycle and I looked over to the right and I saw this bright, glowing white light descending toward the trees. Now, I didn't know what it was, and I didn't think too much about it. Got a little bit alarmed. But as I turned to start riding my bike again, I saw, just a few seconds later, this orange disc floating along at treetop level. After a while, the glow would go out, and you would see this oval-shaped dark mass moving along in front of the clouds. And there was absolutely no sound, which I thought was very, very unusual. The road from there on passes the old apple house my family used to store apples, which was bought in the 50s and remodeled by Hank Query. The road then proceeds along to the hill in front of my farmhouse, and this was a point where I looked up in the sky and I could see this orange disc, this dim orange disc floating along above the trees, and as I made the turn on my bicycle to go up the hill, it was directly over me and it made the turn at the same time. Needless to say, I was pretty frightened by now. This farmhouse at one time had a huge barn in the back of it, which burned a few years ago. The disc then flew across the driveway that night, went out across the pasture, and sat on motionless over some trees. As I watched it, it stayed motionless for a few seconds, made a little jerking motion, and then proceeded to move directly back. It never made a turn. It just moved straight back. As I watched it, it flew back over my head, over the farmhouse and barn, and across the road in a southerly direction toward the village of Hancock. A picture was taken in 1927 in Oregon. It looks very much like what I saw that night. It was taken during the day. I was in the Navy for 4 years, and I operated with carriers and planes, and I never saw anything like what I saw that night. It was absolutely silent as it moved. My father, pictured here, sent me a letter while I was in the service telling me that he'd had that experience as well. We lived on the Peterborough Road in 1970 when I was married, and one night I was walking my dog, and I had virtually the same experience again. White light in the sky, it moved as a red object, it turned dark for a while. I never saw any inhabitants or any lights on it other than the glow. It moved in an easterly direction toward Greenfield, New Hampshire, and disappeared. If anyone's had an experience like this, and wants to compare stories, I'd love to hear from you. So please get in touch with me if you can. Hello, I'm Ed Mulhall. And before I put the finishing touches on this video, I want to make a few things clear. On the night in question in July of 1955, I was 15 years old. I'd been with my friend Bob Fogg and some other friends at his house. I left there about maybe a half an hour before dark that night on my way home. During the course of that trip home on my bicycle, I saw in the sky to the right of me on an old dirt road a bright light in the sky, white, looked like a flare almost, kind of dangling like it was on a string. And I watched this for a few minutes and I didn't have any idea what it was. So I got on my bike and started to ride. And then a few seconds later, to the left of this light appeared a red oval-shaped object over the trees. Now at this point, it's almost dark, not quite dark, but dark enough so I couldn't really make out any features. It slowly moved along over the trees, and every once in a while the light would go out and you'd see this dark mass moving along over the trees. About this time I became quite concerned and frightened, and I rode my bike about as fast as I could up the road, noticing that all the time above me this disc was in a perfect line with me on that road. I reached the corner and the hill before you get to the farmhouse we were living in then, and I saw it turn the corner with me. Now, by this time, I'm desperately terrified, and when I got into the driveway, I tried to get my father to come out and see it. It traveled to the right along the path of our driveway. It continued past the big old barn out back and out to a pasture where it hovered over some trees. And it just remained motionless for a few seconds. And then it moved like that, and it came directly back. It never made a real turn. Like most vehicles would have to make a turn, this did not. It just went straight back, as if it was multi-directional. I watched it disappear over a field and head back to Hancock. Now, I told this story to only a very few close friends and family because every time I tried to tell it somewhere else, I was met with skepticism and some sort of joke or ridicule, and I kind of gave it up. Lately, I decided that after doing some reading and some more research that I would tell this story before I get too old to do it. I want to make sure that perhaps my granddaughter and some other people would have access to this story. If you have an interest in UFOs and you have a similar experience you'd like to relate or compare stories or discuss it in any way, please get in touch with me. I left my email address and my phone number on the credit section of the video. To me, this is an event that happened, a very, very significant event in my life. I was traumatized for a while by it. I don't think I realized at the time what actually had happened until much later. I've read similar stories, and a lot of the stories that I've read or heard about, the person who was had the encounter was only in the presence of the UFO for a few seconds or maybe a few minutes. I calculate that I probably was with this craft, being observed, definitely being observed by this craft, for at least 10 to 12 minutes, maybe longer. So that's some food for thought and consideration. And thanks for watching. I hope you enjoy the presentation.